All right, coming up next for you on Yo TV, we got
footage from the Daly City Health Center.
We got Yo thoughts on mental health. We got Russell stroking this up, Mr. Pickle. And we also got Elliot's Beat Diary. So stay tuned. Welcome back to Yo TV. I'm your host, Am.
And I am
Russell.
Thank you.
And right now we are here in Daly City where the sun is shining. It's a little bit different because usually Daly City is full of fog. But anyway.
Fog town, right?
Something like that.
I don't know. I'm not from here. I don't know what they call it.
Cool.
I do want to let you guys know about the magazine. If you don't know, now you do know. We've been publishing for years and years. This is our monthly magazine. This is generally what it looks like. This is our logo. And what we do is publish writing and art from young people all over the Bay Area and beyond. I mean, from politics to fashion to, you know, culture, society, cell phones, life, love, sex, liberty, things of this nature. And this, of course, is the video version.
You just said sex, and it's funny because this next segment is about the Daly City Youth Health Center. And it's not all about sex, but you get to come here and you don't have to tell your parents. And you get to get free advice about sex, mental health, if you are in like an abusive relationship, you need some immunizations getting on because you go into high school, college, whatever. Anyways, go ahead and check out this next segment and learn a little bit more.
We are the school-based health center for Jefferson Union High School District, which include all of the Daly City and Pacifica schools. I love it. I love teens. I've always loved working with teens because they're at that time of life where there's so much going on and people kind of on the edge of things are really open and they want to make changes, they want to discover things, they're trying to get their acts together.
You know, our tagline is your life, your decisions. And so ultimately we're trying to help them make the right decision. A lot of parents, I think, don't get that about adolescents, that your child will go out because risk-taking is part of development and they'll take risks that hopefully won't hurt them, you know, put them in jail permanently, and that they'll come back to being good adults.
One of the special features of our health center is the extent to which we can provide confidential services to teens, and that is especially the case when teens are in need of some type of birth control method or pregnancy-related services. Testing and treatment for certain sexually transmitted infections. And when those are the kinds of services we're providing, and the young person is under 18, we are not supposed to get parent consent, and we don't. And there's an actual law in California that prohibits us from doing that.
It's nice that women have so many options for birth control so that you can find something that works for you. So, the diaphragm, they come in different sizes. You have to have an exam. They try to measure the space that's around your cervix. You put a spermicidal lubricant inside here, and then it goes over the cervix. It's kind of shaped a little like this with like the hole in the middle, and so it would cover around your cervix. With the IUD, so there's no hole that gets made. The hole's already there, and that would be your cervix. So ultimately, it would slip in through your cervix, and then you would insert it into the uterus. And then there's some strings that you trim off. One that's really popular is called the Mirena IUD, and it can be in you for up to 5 years, but you can take it out at any time. So if it was bothering you, but the nice thing about this is that it's very, very minuscule hormone. And so a lot of people don't get the side effects of, you know, weight gain, moodiness, decreased interest in sex. Plan B, which is the most common emergency contraceptive being used today. In the packaging, it says that it's good for up to 72 hours after sex.
When people come in, pretty much sometimes they're like shy and they're afraid because this is the first time they're coming in for either a reproductive health visit or a pelvic exam. I try to tell them, you know, just relax and be as honest as you can because we're just here to help you. What I do here is I pretty much room all of our patients except for our nurses' patients. So like the nurse practitioner and doctor's patients take their vital signs, which are like their weight, height, blood pressure, temperature, depending on all what they're coming in for. And I set up their exams, do hearing and vision tests, do all the lab work, send them off to the lab, prepare all the specimens, stuff like that. And at first they look at me like, are you my doctor? And I'm like, no, I'm just a medical assistant. They're like, wow, you're so young. Are you still in school? I'm like, no, I already finished. Like, oh, how old are you? And it gets into all this whole big thing. And then when they find out I have a kid, oh my gosh. And but I mean, I try to, you know, treat them all with respect and treat them as if they were my peers also.
We're a primary resource. There aren't many school-based health centers. We provide individual, family, and some group counseling for high-risk teens and young adults. Kids can be referred for truancy, anger issues, depression, anxiety, problems with their peers, parents, partners. There can be abuse issues, physical abuse, sexual abuse, drug and alcohol issues, issues around pregnancy or sexual transmitted infections. So we provide a multitude of services.
I go crazy sometimes.
Yeah, apparently. Look at you, you're going crazy right now.
You were
going
crazy.
My love got you looking so crazy right now, my love.
Oh gosh.
Speaking of crazy.
I'm the crazy one, yeah.
On a more serious note. For this installment of Yo Thoughts, Yo TV went out to San Francisco's Haight Street, Haight-Ashbury District, and we also had some folks out in the suburbs in the Dublin Pleasanton area to talk to young people about mental health, what their definition of mental health was, where they go to get support and help, how they stay sane, would they ever see a therapist, and they came up with some pretty interesting answers, or at least illuminating, and that's this installment of Yo Thoughts. And you're still crazy, girl, right now.
I'm Tanya. I'm from here in San Francisco, and I'm 15.
My name's Keith. I'm 25. I'm from Dublin in Ireland.
Eric Carter, from Riverside, 25.
My name's Layla Sagadi. I'm from here. I live in the city, in the inner sunset. I'm 24 years old.
What I think mental health is there's something in your brain that helps, that affects your concentration, or it makes you emotional, and the emotion part like makes you depressed, and it just affects your concentration.
Mental health is simply being happy and understanding that no matter when times are rough, you know, there's always gonna be a good time coming, and having faith that you're not crazy and you don't need to kill yourself.
How like healthy someone is mentally?
Just general well-being in your mind, being kind of happy with your general state of health. It's hard to define for me.
Mental health is how your mind can affect your emotions, your way of thinking.
Mental health is the opposite of being mentally unhealthy.
I have seen a therapist, actually a couple. When I was going to Kaiser, the woman I saw there wasn't much of help. She almost seemed like she wanted me to have the issues I have. But the nice thing about Kaiser is I went to group therapy, other teenagers, and that helped a lot to know that I wasn't alone.
So I've seen a therapist. I went to about 2 sessions with a therapist because I had emotional problems. I was able to tell them how I felt. I was able to open up to them and let them know what I was feeling, what was going on in my life.
Actually, I didn't feel like therapy helped me that much.
I don't like therapists.
Why not?
Because you can't be like expected to spell out your whole thoughts to someone you don't know.
What would have worked better is if the person had more background on my own personal life, which is why talking with friends was a little more helpful to me.
Who do you talk to a hard time?
Friends and family, I suppose, you know.
A good friend.
My friends.
What are my friends?
Mainly my close friends.
Yeah, she's the one that I talk to when I'm feeling sad.
Who do you talk to on tough times?
Her, I guess.
Is that just you said you?
Yeah.
Okay.
I do a lot of things to stay sane. I wrestle, I write songs, I play bass, I just write sometimes. Sometimes I just draw, go for walks, listen to music. Basically, whatever's available to me.
If I can't just sit still and be okay, I just write out everything. Like, write out my emotions and stuff like that.
Okay, how do you keep yourself from going crazy?
Find friends, find a hobby, something that interests you,
what
maybe.
What are your hobbies?
School. That actually makes you a little bit crazy. And sports, basketball.
Keeping myself busy with things that I like to do so I don't dwell on the problems of life, stuff like that.
I make sure that there's time for myself every day. I take time to think about the events and things that are going on in my life.
Mm-hmm. All right, yo, TV, don't go nowhere because we'll be right back.
Hey everybody, here we are at the beautiful and illustrious In-N-Out Burger in Daly City.
Oh, and Krispy Kreme.
And Krispy Kreme, they came together, it's like a package deal. And I just had a double-double, animal style, so I have a bit of a burger baby in my belly. Say that five times fast. But I just wanted to tell you guys about a publication called The Beat Within. It's a sister publication to Yale Youth Outlook, our magazine. They've been around 10 years since 1996, the death of Tupac, which, can you believe it's been 10 years? Essentially what they do is they go into Bay Area juvenile halls and they conduct writing workshops, getting young people who are detained there to write about their experiences in their lives, and they publish it in a weekly newsletter. And now we've taken it to the next level.
Taking it with video. We got Elliot to tell his story to us. He comes from Oakland, he likes to drive cars, and he likes the Yoda vans. Those are Toyota Prius. Anyways, next up is him, so go ahead and check it out.
My childhood was sort of difficult. Not having any younger siblings, it was just like me and my mom, because my dad passed when I was about 3, 4. So it was basically me and my mom. I don't think I have any male role models, because a role model would be someone you would look up to and like to follow their footsteps in a way. But I had nobody like that. I kind of had my own idea of what I wanted to do. The people I used to hang out with, they used to hang out on the block, so that's where I was at. Like when I was young, I'd get kind of bored and get into trouble. So one day me and my friend were bored. And we got in some trouble, still in the car. That was my first case on the block. That's where I learned there was a lot of people stealing what they call Yoda vans. I've been driving since I was 12 because my mom's friend Leroy, he used to teach me how to drive. He would let me drive like every car. It was like I would usually, like when I was young, I would hold the steering wheel and he would have the pedals. But then once I got older, I got to really drive, get in the front seat and be by myself alone. I put a lot of time into my car. I mean, I'm always trying to fix something, like to make it look, you know, just perfect.
I'm taking this stuff I don't like off.
Completed. Ugly piss,
right? Yeah, that's been keeping me busy. I mean, my mom was kind of mad, but then once she seen I was focusing fixing my car instead of doing bad things, she wasn't tripping anymore. The hardest part since I've been out is controlling my attitude to keep me out of trouble. Because it's not been like I've been catching cases outside of school. It's been inside of school is what's been getting me in trouble. I caught another case at school. But ever since then, it was like a third time slap in the face. It's been good. The thing that's helped me is working with the beat and yo. That's really helped me. I don't think I would have stayed out of trouble if I didn't have a job. I think I would have been out doing the same thing, breaking curfew, and just the same stuff. I want to get through high school. If I do go to college, I want to study for journalism and business. I found out what I wanted to do by just being with my mom. It was sort of like, I seen her as a hard worker and just very supportive at times, very caring, and since she was on her own, it was very hard for her and she still made it. So I kind of wanted to follow those footsteps. My mom thinks I'm doing really good, the fact that I'm staying out of trouble. But before, she was really disappointed. She never knew that I would have ended up like that or getting in trouble like that. Because I'm still a good kid, it's just that I picked the wrong decisions to do. One main plan of the summer is to stay out of trouble. Because there's a lot of things that go down, a lot of parties, a lot of just everything. A lot of people out that just start, that's, you know, like to start trouble. So I would like to just make my way around that and stay away from it and just work on what I need to do. You can expect me to be off probation and, you know, just looking real good, trying to do something for myself.
Our friend Elliot is set to get off probation in summer, so we'll come back and do a Beat Diary sequel with him, check up on, see how he's doing. For right now though, we have to say goodbye briefly and send you to a commercial, but stick around, we'll be right back.
All right, Yo TV, we are here hanging out at the Daly City Skate Park. It's kind of crummy, but whatever, you guys play here. And next for you, we got Who Got Handles. It's all about basketball put on by the DJ Project. We got females doing this three-point shootout stuff. I don't know, it looks kind of hard. Check it out for yourself.
Well, pretty much, it's a youth organization that is geared towards the youth, ages 14 to 24, that has to, you know, keep them out of the streets and keep them out of, you know, that's what I say, situations that may endanger them. And pretty much what we do is we teach them, you know, life skills and business skills through, you know, hip-hop culture. We have an audio production class, a songwriting class, a breakdancing class. We have right now we're doing event production. As you can see, the youth put this together in the DJ Project through Maeep. We try to, you know, empower the youth with skills that are vital for them to be, you know, useful in the workforce, you know, today in America, and just, you know, give them the place to let out or vent, you know, the frustrations or whatever they had. It's, you know, for some it's a kind of a therapy because, you know, they take, you know, the DJ Project with a passion because they have, you know, a passion with music. Some of them love to make beats, some of them just love to dance. I mean, you know, it's just a way to escape.
Today, I came here into the three-point shootout contest, and I made it to the third round.
Hey everybody, we love you. Thank you for joining us, but sadly, again, it is time to bid adieu, which is French, I think, for kind of like goodbye or see you later, or we'll kick it at a later date. In the meantime, if you're trying to find us, we are online everywhere. You can see us at youthoutlook.org. Find video clips there. You can see everything else we have from, you know, photography, articles, work that I've done, work that Ann's done. You can also email us if you miss us. How do they do that, Ann?
At YoTV at youthoutlook.org. You send everything to us. And you can also check us out on MySpace. Add us as your friend. We'll add you.
That's the exchange. That's how it works, right? Build your network.
Something like that.
Excellent. Thank you so much. We love you.
And we'll see you next time.
Take care.
All right, we are in Daly City at Mr. Pickles. Coming up next for you on Yo TV, we got...
Russell doesn't know.
I'm sorry, I was so distracted by Mr. Pickle. I was just trying to make a friend. Beat Diary, how could you forget that?
All About Elliot. And then...
Then we got to do Mr. Pickles' Beat Diary.
The Beat Diary with Elliot. Okay.
I saw myself in the reflection in the lens going like this. Beat Diary. We also have Health Center. I'm about to contract a virus for Mr. Pickle. This is our magazine, Yo Youth Outlook. We've been publishing. What have we been doing? Publishing? At bitches ain't adieu. Adieu, adieu, adieu.